Today, I get to show you the new game feature, Wasteland War. Welcome back to another Bit Legends video. Oh my goodness, this one's hot off the cuff. They just came out with a patch on what is it, Saturday? And look at this. So when it starts off, you pick a faction. You got blue, yellow, green, no green, blue, yellow, red, and pick a team and you just go for it, man. So we start off at Flame City. If you click on this, you can kind of see what's going on here. You can see you're getting production for each of these buildings. The more of the map that you control, the more stuff you get. Whoever has the most stuff wins the thing. Exciting. So, as you can see, you follow these lines. So you start off at your main town city. You'll have to use a resource in the top right corner that's for movement. So if I want to move from Flame City over to Fury Fortress, that costs. And then I gotta move to Colosseum and so on and so on. When I first started, this top corner was completely grayed out, kind of like Windy Mine is now. And I've been using all of my attacks to try to capture it. So there you go. Yellow trying to come in, but it looks like we have taken the Blizzard spot. So that's probably gonna keep them off of our lands for a little bit. But yeah, there you go. So we are red. Let me see if I can click on anything that's useful. So I did read through this. You pick a team. You got Sandlock, Skyfire. Red is Skyfire. That's us. Niterhog. And then you want to occupy as many strongholds, get all the points and the good things. There you go. And you win the stuff and the things. And you go up in ranks too. You'll see spam at the top of the screen when somebody kills somebody else. That's pretty cool. So I like it, man. Goodness gracious. But let's show some content in just a second. First time really taking a look at the map. So yeah, I'm learning, you're learning, we're all learning. Let's go do it. So here I am, 80% captures it. So Skyfire has it by 80%. That's why we captured it. This is giving us 1,000 gold per day, 1,000 gold per day. Let's click on another one, probably. Yep, you guessed it, 1,000 gold per day. Let's click over here and see. So this one is, I guess Yellow's taking it back because they're probably pissed off that we're blocking this. I think if we block it, then they don't get any. Damn, this gives diamonds. They don't get any points from it. That's what I'm assuming there. But as long as we keep this, which we apparently need to go to defeat it. If Sandlock gets this to 80%, then we would lose it. And if we lose this connection, that's the only connection keeping all this top stuff. So my plan is to take Windy Mine, then move over here to Kira or Blizzard and just try to stave it off. I'll probably go to Blizzard so I can try to capture Heroes Hall, and I'll just stay there maybe for the remainder of the 2 weeks. All the stuff resets at 2 weeks. I see gems here. What is this? 40 gems per day. Look at that. Look at that. So exciting, man. Exciting. Holy smokes. For them to pump out a new game feature so quick, that's crazy. As far as team, you go in there with your PvP team. I'll show that. For awards, take a look at this. So the rankings, if I click on rankings at the top corner, that is not a button, so nothing is happening. These are the resources that you use to attack or to move. And then you get a bunch of bounty points. I don't really know what bounty points do. They look like they're the elimination. The currency you get from elimination, and then rankings. Look at that. Oh, interesting. There's a lot of familiar faces on there. I'm all the way down at 20. So let's get at it. Let's go. I don't know if you get points by if someone attacks you, you defend it and they lose. I don't know how that works, but you do get points for attacking. So let's go do that. Make sure volume's down. If I have my in-game sounds on, then YouTube tries to copyright my video, and we don't want that. But here we go. So, I am a tanky boy. I've made a bunch of videos about different talent builds. There is a bounty hunter tank build that I'm currently using right now. I'm actually quite interested in. Boom, mount skill in the face. I am interested in going to Kung Fu Tank. I just want to wait to switch until I have enough experience so I can get either level 50 in Kung Fu, preferably level 70, is when the bonus is really kind of tipping the favor. But I don't want to jump over too quick and change my build and then become a little bit weaker, even if I'm going to be stronger in the long run. I don't want to gimp anybody's raid team, so they might need me. So there you go. You can see Skyfire going up. When Skyfire gets that to 80%, we should be able to, you know, do the thing and get it. Also, take a look at a dating mech. He's doing damage. He's doing damage. He's doing well. But yeah, so we did a video with Bounty Hunter Tank, Bounty Hunter DPS, and Kung Fu Tank, which should surprise some people. A lot of you guys, I made so much noise about Bounty Hunter, a lot of people that went Kung Fu, because Kung Fu just sounds cool, were like, whoa, are we not a good build? Is that not a thing? I think hands down, for DPS build, Bounty Hunter, there's no question. You get tons of SP, tons of damage. It's everything that you would want as a DPS player. And, I mean, it's amazing. Hats off to the dev. To the dev team for coming up with something that's so cool. It's exactly what you want to see in a game like this. You know, it's got the RPG element. You've got synergies between the traits and just everything's. I can't complain. It's amazing. Ooh, look at that reflect in your face. I love reflect build. Knowing that there's more, there's not just GVG, there's not just PvP, there's also this. This war mode, it really, really, really makes me want to get a deflect build and just get as much deflect as possible. But we'll see how that happens. But yeah, so the DPS Bounty Hunter is amazing. I just got completely shreked there. Hopefully, if I can take him out quickly, then this still should have a chance. It's one of those things where, like, I just won like 15 or 20 different battles in a row before this. And I'm like, I was thinking, as soon as I film, I'm probably gonna get some bad RNG and lose. Actually, I think he's too squishy. Let me take him out. You want to take the character out because he's got all the bonus damage craziness on him. And I don't want to lose. I do think DPS characters are very, very scary in PvP, so you definitely gotta respect their authority. Especially the pet proc. To my knowledge, the pet proc ignores pet damage, ignores defensive. So if you got full block or full damage reduction, it doesn't really matter. That is not 100% confirmed, but that seems to be the way that it is. And yeah, so a pet proc can definitely take out your tank in one, maybe two shots. And yeah, when that happens, things get scary. Especially since I don't run a backup tank, which I could, but I want faster fights. But there we go. We're getting through it. That is Hellmantis. I might end up doing a video on him sometime, someday. Not so much because he's high on my list of stuff I want to make, but more that he is, I think I'm like either halfway done with him or closer than that. I have four more attacks. I hope if I can cap this before I, Nyra, if I can cap this before I run out of attacks, that would be cool. That'd be cool. I think you can buy more attacks with gems. I hope that's not necessarily the meta, where it's just whatever team wants to throw the most gems at this does it, but we'll see. Either way, I'm very, very excited to see how it goes. And I think the currency rewards is elimination, so that's always welcome. Boom, mount skill. He is gone. We got a nice little reflect in there. Beautiful. Nyra is a glass cannon, so if I can, there we go, let's go autopilot. If he hits me, he will break whatever he touches, but if I can snipe him out, then there you go. Feeling good about it. I definitely plan on getting a lot more deflect, whether I go Kung Fu or whether I go stay with a bounty hunter. I can do whatever. I have enough books and experience on me right now. If I wanted to, I could probably just do... I could probably get like level 30, level 40. I think it's like level 45 if I used all my experience on Kung Fu right now. Those of you wondering what the heck I'm doing jumping around, this is gonna be a dangerous team. What am I doing jumping around from class to class? Well, obviously I wanna show videos off for you guys. Also, once I get to like 93, 94, something like that, that's a lot of damage, man. Ooh. And that was my Hawkeye reflex right there. Giving me a deflect, I believe. Once I get to like 94, there's not really anything I'm too excited about. Let me just take him out for like one hit. Nothing I'm too excited about. And I really need to kill Bop. That did nothing, and he blocked it. He has block? Seriously? This guy, he's gonna be the guy with block. I wanna kill him before his pet destroys me. I lost my whole train of thought when I almost died. And now let's do the switcheroo. I don't like healing in PvP, but that is what we're doing right now. Anyways, lost my entire train of thought. The iron dragon, iron raptor looking thing is one of the bosses from Raid 6. Or is it Raid 7? I think it's Raid 6. And he just destroys your team, so seeing him is kind of giving me PTSD. I can't focus. But we'll do that. There's my ultimate ability. I'm going to miss that ultimate ability, possibly, when I go Kung Fu. The main thing is, in PvP, what's cool is I'm getting all this SP, and I can use mount skills, so that's very significant in PvP, because if I can snipe one of the characters, like, for example, if that mount skill actually did some damage on Bop, this would be a whole lot easier fight. But whatever. We'll get it. If I can get him down, there we go. And then now it should be just straightforward from here. I might lose one or two guys, but I don't care. But we are getting it in as attack target. Take out Pioneer. There we go. Not too bad. So, nice Pioneer heals, get everybody healthy, and then we can just autoplay that for a second. So yeah, I don't know. Last train of thoughts. I'm loving the Bounty Hunter DPS. I think it is amazing. It's everything that you would hope for in a RPG character build with talents like this. To have talents in a game like this is just amazing. As far as the tanks, Bounty Hunter tank is a great spec. The main thing is, are there going to be some sort of amazing weapons that you can use all that SP? Or, you know, if you're not really using the SP, while it is nice to have on you, is not that valuable, you know? And if your DPS are like mine and they're just blowing everything up, I might get no attacks each fight, if we're talking about raid, or I might get like one or two attacks off if we're talking like world boss or boss fights. So, ooh, look at that deflect. God. That's beautiful. That's beautiful. Mount skill, boom. But yeah, that'll be the main thing that I'll miss, is being able to get a bunch of SP really quick and popping off a mount skill. However, with zero SP, if I go Kung Fu, I can shield my entire team. So, I mean, it's pretty nice. Pretty nice there. Does he not have a mount? Can you turn off the mount cosmetic? If you can turn off the mount cosmetic, that might be the underdog of the whole video. It might be the dark horse. Target skill, boom. A lot of people are running the Hellmantis, probably just because his fusions are pretty common. It's nothing too special there. I'm rocking the huge sword boss. You can see right there. There is a cool fusion with him that I'm hoping to bring to you guys. All right, we hit 80, and I think that might have been my last attack, or maybe I have one more. I've got one more attack or movement or anything. I don't think there's any point for me to move there. I really don't think there's any point for me to move there. I don't know if standing there does anything. I think you move there, then it asks you to defend, but this cannot be attacked because got the gun finally. Dude, Bop got the gun, fellas. He's the guy using the sword in all my raid videos. That is nice. That is nice. He's been looking for that for a while, so that's really good. So I guess if I move here, I'm just out. What I want to do is move all the way to Blizzard so I can defend or do the Heroes Hall thing. What percentage is this? I think there's probably somebody up there. Nope, nobody's touching that thing. Okay, let's move over there. And then now I'm out of juice, so it says I can't do enough. For the purposes of this video, I will... It's only 100, but it's only 5. Oof, that sucks. For the video, boys, for the gram. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5... So, I did want to show this. So, each time I move, it costs an action, which kind of sucks, but I get it. I think what's going to happen is I'm going to stay here and defend, but I also want to attack this, and I'd have to... Was I getting 10% each time I attack something? Was that 100? At least it's 100, not 1,000. How long is this video going on? We're at 15 minutes. Yeah, all right, here's the deal. So you guys have seen me capture something. You just whack at it until you get it. You get it to 80%, you capture it. I'm going to use my last little pip to defend here. I probably will attack that thing, but I don't know. We'll figure it out. I don't want to make these videos too much more than 15 minutes. As always, I appreciate you guys for watching. Let me click that button. Defend. Oh, I know what defend does. Defend helps your percentages. That's what's going on here. I thought I was thinking defend makes you just like stay there, and so people have to fight you if they attack that one. I don't really think that's how it works. I think defend just ups your percentages and makes things, you know, makes the thing do the stuff. But look at that. Oh, I'm excited, man. A new mode. We did not see them do the guild update where you can use your guilds as friends. You can no longer transfer PvP coins into ace tokens, so that's kind of unfortunate. I've got this on auto. I actually don't want it on auto. Do I have enough single target snipe? Let's take him out because he doesn't have a lot of juice. He's got attack furthest, which I want to save it so I can do attack target next time. Bump, bump, bump. Yeah, so you can't convert PvP coins into ace tokens anymore, which is unfortunate. I think you still get 10 ace tokens a day on regen-ish, but I think it caps at 5. So the problem there is you need 10 tokens to buy a class profession book, but you can only regen up to 5. It caps at 5, so I don't really get that. Is this attack target? Yes, it is. Bang. A huge sword boss. Anyways, not sure. I might actually post this video before the other one just because, you know, it's news and I want to get the info out there sooner than later. You know, maybe I'll post it now. Anyways, so depending on whenever I post this video, we've got build videos coming up. They definitely should watch them. Kung Fu Tank, Bounty Hunter Tank, Bounty Hunter DPS, Engineer. Let's not talk about that. As always, I appreciate you guys for watching, and I will see you in the next video.